pole of the magnet is facing the north, geographic north. Is that clear to all? This time we are having south pole facing the geographic north. So how the earth magnetic field will be? This is the earth magnetic field, north, south. This is geographic north, geographic south. This is clear. So earth magnetic field will be in this direction. Okay. Now magnetic field of this magnet and the magnetic field of the earth, they will be interacting with each other. Okay. And we will have the result end of that. So see here. So earth magnetic field, its direction is in this direction. Okay. From its straight line equidistant from each other. Now how the magnetic field lines of the and the magnetic field lines of the magnet, they are from north to south. These are the magnetic field lines. So the area around the magnet, that is enclosed vicinity to the magnet, will have the strong magnetic field because of the magnet. Okay, strong magnetic field because of the magnet we are having. So this is the magnetic field. Now see here, magnetic field lines of the earth, they are in this direction as well, these are in this direction, so they will be added here. So because of addition, they will be more closer to each other. That means that it means the field strength is more here. It will be the magnetic field strength will increase because they will add, because they are adding each other. Okay. Now as we are moving away from the magnet, the field strength of the magnet, it is decreasing. It is decreasing. So these lines will be becoming more of a straight line. These lines will be getting more of a straight line, and as we are moving away from the magnet, they are becoming more and more straight line, parallel to each other. Okay, they are getting straight line. Have you understood this one? It means that the magnetic strength of the magnet is decreasing. So if this magnet won't have impact as we are moving away, so we are again getting the straight line, that is of the earth magnetic field. This is clear. Now see here, what happens on this side and this side. So you can see here, magnetic field lines, they are going inside. So this is the magnetic field line of the magnet. But see here, what happens here? Magnetic field line of the earth, that is in that direction, in this direction, and this direction. So somewhere, as we are moving away from the magnet, its magnetic field is decreasing. So somewhere, magnetic field strength of the magnet becomes equal to the magnetic field earth of the earth. Is this clear? Their magnetic field will become equal to each other, but they are opposite in direction. But they are opposite in direction. So what will happen? They will neutralize each other. They will cancel each other, and we'll get neutral point somewhere here. Is this clear? So resultant magnetic field line, how this will be? So see here, as you are moving this part, magnetic field line of the magnet is in this direction, and earth magnetic field in this direction. So they will have the resultant something like this. Okay, at far they are becoming more of a parallel line. Similarly here on this side. Okay. And here it is reducing. Okay, leave this one. And here, okay, they are getting more of a parallel now, because in this side, there will be no impact of the magnet, no impact of the magnetic field of the magnet. And somewhere here, they neutralize each other. That means it means the magnetic field strength of the magnet becomes equal to the magnetic field strength of the earth. And such at such point, they will cancel each other because they are in opposite direction. They are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So they will neutralize each other. And at such, similarly, we have one point here as well. And these points are called as neutral points. That is, the magnetic field strength of the magnet is neutralized by the magnetic field strength of the earth. Or the magnetic field strength of the earth is neutralized by the magnetic field strength of the magnet. At this point, the magnetic needle, it will rest in any direction. It will rest in any direction. There is no magnetic field here. So these are the neutral points. Is this clear? So any doubt in here?
Sir, it means we have the neutral points in all the directions, east, west, north and south.
Yeah, it will depend how we place the magnet.
And sir, so the magnitude drawn on this adding. Board.
See here, on this side they are adding. But as the direction changes, at this side they are parallel, so they are adding. But see here, somewhere here. Is that okay? Somewhere here, the direction of the magnetic field of the earth is in this direction, earth magnetic field here. So, resultant will be somewhere in between, depending on the who's at this mode. Okay, so this is the resultant magnetic field. So, we can take, for example, this is the magnetic field line of the magnet, and this is the magnetic field line of the earth. Now, resultant we are getting in this side, more diverted towards the magnet because magnet is having more stronger field as compared to earth in the vicinity. So this is the resultant direction. Is this clear?
And so the magnet you have drawn on this board, what about its neutral points? It have its point.
Yes. Neutral points we got. So
it have only two neutral points. East and north and south.
It will have only two. It can't have here. See here. Here, what's the direction of the magnetic field strength of the magnet? In this direction, and the earth as well in this direction. So they are going to add each other. So only the places where they are opposite in direction and equal in magnet. So see here, there are points here as well. Here, the earth magnetic field strength is more. Here the earth magnetic field strength is more as compared to the magnetic field. They are opposite in direction but not in magnitude. Here the earth magnitude is more, so it will have more component of the earth magnetic field. At this point, it is having equal magnitude but opposite direction. At this point, its magnetic strength is more as compared to the earth magnetic strength. So it will follow the direction of this one, component of this one it will have. So it will show this direction. Needle will show this direction. So you can do one thing. As you place the needle here. Now, the needle will show in this direction. As you are moving away, strength is decreasing. But still, it will show in the direction here. Here, any direction. Now, after that, direction will be opposite. In earth magnetic field. Is this clear? So here, they will become...
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So once can you explain how we can, you know, identify the neutral point?
Okay, neutral point, how to identify? Okay, basically, okay, your needle you take, okay, and it is pointing this direction. Now as you are moving, and after this point, it will start to change the direction. Earlier it was pointing this direction. After this point, it will start to change the direction. So at this point, that after this point, now, take the needle and shake it once and put it here and try to rotate the needle. It will be any direction it can be. So at this point it can place, it will be showing any direction. As you rotate the needle will as well rotate. Okay, right, slowly rotate the needle at this point. But as you are keeping the needle here, as you rotate the needle, the needle will always point in this direction. And here, rotate the needle, it will always point in this direction. But at this point, it will rotate a bit. Like this, in any direction it can show.
So, sir, the place where the needle rotates all the 360 degrees, that is the neutral point?
Not all the 360, any direction. Any direction we would say. See, system or any it can rest at any angle out of the 360 degree. Okay. Or we can make any angle like this, anywhere it can rest. Okay?
Sir, other than north and south?
No, no. It can show any direction, north as well, south as well. Here, there will be no magnetic field. So there will be no impact on the magnetic needle. So it can rest in any direction. Can be rest in south. So as you move the needle, as you rotate the needle will as well rotate. Did you all think, it's in glass case, as you rotate the glass case, the needle as well will rotate. Since there is no magnetic field to impact it, magnetic, the needle, so it can rotate in any way. Here?
And sir, if you rotate the compass near at the pole of the south pole, then it will not change its direction.
Here. Here, you rotate the needle. Glass case is rotated, but needle will always keep pointing like that. It won't change.
Okay, sir.
Okay, if I take the needle here, if I rotate it, its direction won't change. It will always, okay, just wait a minute, I can bring the needle, I'm having one. Just give me 10 seconds. Yeah, just see here, it's the needle. So as I rotate it, it is always pointing towards north, this direction. Because of the earth magnetic field is affecting it. Is this clear? But at this point, there is no magnetic field strength. So it won't affect it. It won't have impact on the needle. Is this clear now? Anything more to ask?
Yes, sir. It's
sir,
clear.
It means that, sir, it means that a needle is not moving in, a needle is moving in any direction. That shows that there is no impact of magnetism at that point.
Okay. Rather than moving, we can say that it rests in any direction. Since there is no impact, so it won't
move. It rests in any direction.
Yes, it rests in any direction. That will be more appropriate word. Okay. Any more doubts? Okay, now we can start tight. In that, we'll be discussing magnetic field again. So tides occur because of the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun. And which will have more impact? Which have more gravitational pull? Sun or the moon?
Sun. Excuse me,
sun,
sir.
What?
Sun.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, so can you give it a little a short summary of what you taught in the last class.
See, that's ocean current. It was totally different from this one. Ocean current we discussed last. Weren't you present there?
Sir, actually due to some problem, I left the class in the middle. Then I rejoined again. After some time.
Do one thing, I uploaded the video, the whole class video. You can go through that for time being, okay?
Okay, sir.
Every day, every class video I'm uploading, the whole video I'm uploading. So, you can go through that.
Okay, sir.
Today, due to limitation of the time as well, I won't be able to revise the whole again. Okay, so types we're discussing. So sun has more gravity as compared to the moon. But moon is having more impact on the formation of the tide. Moon plays major role than the sun. Why? Because moon is closer to the earth. That's why its gravitational pull is more on earth than as compared to the sun. Okay? So It is because of the gravitational pull of the moon. So if this is Earth, and here we are having the moon, and here we are having the sun. Sun is very far away from the Earth. Its gravity is more as compared to the moon, but sun is very far away from the Earth. Therefore, its gravitational pull is less as compared to the moon. So its gravitational pull is twice as compared to the sun. Moon's gravitational pull is twice as compared to the sun. So because of the moon and the sun, we are having tides, and major role is played by the moon. Because of the moon, we can say we are having the tides, that is low tides or high tides. So what happens here? Now, what does gravity do? It attracts towards it, Earth is attracting moon towards it, and the sun towards it. As the sun is attracting Earth towards it, moon towards it. And what moon is doing? Moon is attracting the Earth towards it. So there is an attraction. So now see what happens. Now moon is attracting Earth towards it. What will happen? Earth will move a little bit towards it. But water being fluid, it will be more attracted, and it. So what happens? A bulge happens here. Water is being attracted here. Water moves in this direction. At this time, I am neglecting the effect of sun. Okay. So here, water level decreases. Okay. So water gets attracted towards the moon, and bulge is formed. And this we call as high tide. And what happens here? This we call as low tide. Low tide on the both side. And what happens on the opposite? As well, the high tide occurs. Reason for this one? Here, moon is attracting this side. So why we are having bulge on this side? Anyone in class?
So to make them equal in both the directions.
Okay, I didn't go to clear your claim because it's liquid or something. Okay, see here, what happened?
Sir, she is telling that to make it the equal, you know, in the opposite direction.
But how the water will know that we have to make it equal? Some reason has to be there.
Vertically opposite angle.
No.
So.
Yes.
Sir, the mass.
Okay, see, I'll give you one example. Okay, just see here. This is one container. I have placed water in it, poured water in it, filled water in it. Okay, now as I pull the this container towards me, what will happen to the water? Here the bulge will form, water will here, or may splash out as well. Yes or no? So this is because of Newton's law. Law of inertia. Since I have pulled the container, what happens to the water? Water wants to stay in its own position. That is, it is in rest. It wants to stay in rest. So it will resist any change. So what happens? A bulge will form here. This water do not want to move in this direction. So with this container moves, so all the water moves upward. And a bulge is formed. Similar thing happened here. What happens here? Moon attracted the Earth. So this lithosphere of the Earth is being moved towards the moon. So Earth moves towards the moon. Okay? A little bit it moves. But water, being fluid, it is more moving, more attracted. So what happens this here? This side. The Earth moved a little bit towards the moon. So here what happens? Water was already there. But because of inertia, this water do not want to move towards the moon. Since because of inertia, this water do not, so a bulge will be formed here. Okay, now some space will be remaining here, this water will move in this direction. So on this side, there is no effect of gravitational pull on the of the moon. Moon gravitational pull is less on this side, but here bulge is formed because of inertia, and here the bulge is formed because of gravitational pull of the moon. Is this clear now? So here the water remains in its own position. Because of inertia, do not want to move. And that's how bulge is formed. Is this clear?
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes.
Sir, we know that Earth have more gravitational force than Moon.
Okay, I got it. 3 years, Earth is having more gravitational pull than the moon. So what will happen 3 years? Earth attracts moon, so moon moves more towards the Earth as compared to Earth moving towards the moon. Both move, but Earth moves lesser as compared to the moon moving towards the Earth. Is this clear?
So why not moon get stuck to Earth?
This is because of it is moving around the Earth. It is having some speed towards the it is moving in, it is revolving around the Earth. Now see here, because of rotation towards the Earth, because of revolution towards the Earth, it is having centrifugal force as well. Gravitation pull is, that is, we can say that as the centripetal force, but it is having centrifugal force as well. Okay, you can do one thing, have one stick and use a rubber band, tie one iron ball here. As you rotate, it moves away from it, the string gets stretched. Yes or no? String gets stretched, there is only the centrifugal force, the elastic force, but still it gets stretched. That is because of the centrifugal force. Because of that, it is not getting or falling onto the moon, into the Earth.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, see, both are having force. So, it will attract it and it will attract each other. But since Earth is having more force, so it will be, the moon will move more towards Earth. Earth will as well move, but less towards the moon. Is this clear? This is same as well. You can take two magnets. Okay? Bigger one, the smaller one. As you move the smaller magnet towards the bigger magnet, it will also moving. It is moving as well. So when they are attached to each other, you can see less distance is covered by the bigger magnet as compared to the smaller magnet. This you are seeing? Similar thing you can see here.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, then why is that moon is not getting a bulge?
Okay. Water is not there, so we can't say any tide. But okay.
Solid.
I don't know much about the moon. That its axis, how its shaped axis is there. It may be bulgy. I'll see that in our night today. So it must be bulgy. It depends on if this is the Earth. What's the axis of the moon? That I don't know. I have no idea about that axis. So if this is the Earth, if this is the axis of the Earth, moon, then it will be bulgy a bit, for sure. As it rotates on its own axis as well, because of that as well, it will be bulgy. So that I'll search over, then only I can tell. Okay. First, let me confirm.
Okay.
Okay, moon. Okay, I tell you one thing more. Moon has one more impact. Earth axis is tilted 23.5, so it is more in this position because of the moon as well. If there would have been no moon, this axis would have been changing. So since moon is there, this changes are about only 1 degree. This changes about only 1 degree. That is, axis is changing by about 1 degree only, within 1 degree. If moon would have been there, the axis would have been changed much. We would have been more different kind of climate on or seasons on. So moon is helping us. Okay, now we discuss. So reasons we have discussed. Now we discuss two special tides. That is spring tides and neap tides. So see here what happens. This is our Earth, Sun. Okay. Now the moon will be revolving around the Earth. This is clear. Moon will be revolving around the Sun. So at different positions, they will have different poles. At this position, Earth is being attracted by the Sun in this direction, Moon in this direction. So resultant will be somewhere here, the high tide. Okay. As it is moving, high tide. At this position, okay. Take this position first. If Moon is here, what will happen? Okay, I have gone much far. If Moon is here, what will happen? In this position, it is new Moon. It is new Moon. So at this position, what will happen? Sun is attracting the Earth towards in this direction. Moon as well attracting this direction. So both the pull will be added. There will be more gravitation pull. So earth water will have the more gravitational pull, and this bulge will be more. This bulge will be more. Similarly here, the bulge will be more, the inertia bulge, because of inertia. And here bulge because of gravitational pull. So since gravitational pull is more, so earth will be moving a little bit more towards it, and here the more bulge will be there. So on the opposite, we have the high bulge, that is large bulge we have. Here we have the low tide. Here we have the high tide. So such high tides, they are called as swing tides. Now see a tidal range at any place. So see here, this is the land, this is the sea. Okay. So this is the lowest tide that could occur that day. And the highest tide, this one. This is the high tide. And on such day, it is called as spring tide. This difference, this is tidal range. Tidal range difference between the high tide and the low tide. This height is called as tidal range. That is, what is the range of the tide? That is the lowest tide and the high tide. What is the difference? This is called as tidal range. So on this day, this will be the highest. This tidal range will be highest, and this we call as spring tidal range. This will be the highest. Is this clear? Since here the gravitational pull is added, sun as well moon. So we'll have the highest tides on this day. Okay? Same phenomena will occur if this is the earth, sun, and moon is here. Okay? At this time also, bulge will be here the, on this side. The moon is attracting, on this side, the sun is attracting. So again, we have the high bulge. So here we have the high bulge, here is the high bulge. And here we have the low tides, here we have the high tides. High tides and low tides. This is also called as spring tides. So spring tides occurs on new moon and full moon. New moon and full moon. So moon rotates reverse around the earth in 28 days. So if it is here, after 14 days, moon will be here. So we see two times in a month it occurs. Okay. Spring tides are there at a difference of 14 days, I think. Around 14 days, about 14 days. So high tides are occurring. Okay. And in a day, twice. In a day, tides occur twice, because once here the position will be there, and after here. Is this clear?
Okay, sir. Sir, I have a doubt. Yes. Sir, is really a high tide higher than a low tide?
Yes, it is higher. That's why it is called a high tide. Here the low tide will be forming. Here high, low tide. This difference may decrease. This difference keep on decreasing. The tidal range keeps on decreasing or increasing, keeps on changing. Tidal range keeps on changing, depending on the position of the moon and the sun around the earth. Okay, one thing I want to tell you, I forgot. Okay, see here. So see here, how many earth revolves, okay, take it like this, this is moon. Solar day, you already know it is 24 hours. In 24 hours, earth rotates on its axis by one rotation, it rotates by one rotation. This is clear. But if we take moon as stationary now, how the earth rotates? It takes 24 hours, 56 minutes. 54, I think. Okay, 52 minutes. Okay, the lunar day is of 24 hours.
23 hours.
Yes. No, see, this is 23 hours, so that 56 minutes and goes. Okay, but take it as 24 hours. Here the lunar day is of 24 hours, 52 minutes. Lunar day. It is lunar day. It is lunar day. It is like this. The same part of the earth. It will be here in front of the moon again after 24 hours, 52 minutes. I've understood this one. So earth is revolving around the moon. Earth is also rotating on its axis. So after 24 hours, 52 minutes, the same place will be facing the moon again. And that day we call it lunar day. Lunar day, you understood? Lunar day. Solar day, the same place of the earth. It will be after 24 hours facing the sun again. Is this clear? So lunar day is longer than the solar day. So because moon is revolving around the sun, around the moon, earth, therefore after some time here, as it rotates, moon will be somewhere here. So it takes 24 hours, 52 minutes for the same place to look at the moon again. So it is 24 hours, 52 minutes. So see here, if once the bulge is formed here, after 12 hours, 26 minutes, it will be here. Again, we have the bulge. After 12 hours, 26 minutes, we'll have the again the high tide. So in a day, around two bulges occur, around two high tides occur, and two low tides. This is the frequency of the tides. In a day, around two high tides and two low tides occur, majorly. Is this clear? Have you understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we discuss the neap tide. Okay. Neap tide means when this tidal range is less, when the difference is least. Highest spring tide, least neap tide. So when it can occur?
So when this moon and earth are not in stage.
Yes, see here. Now see here. Sun is here, moon is revolving. So see here, somewhere here, moon is pulling towards it, sun is pulling towards it. So bulge will be here somewhere. But it will be less as compared to spring tide. But what happens when the moon is here? That is, they are in 90 degrees. Okay, at right angles they are. So what happens here now? See here, moon, it will attract towards it. It will, more attraction will be here. So very little bulge will be here. But as the sun is attracting this side, sun, moon is attracting this side. So very less bulge will be there. So in such position, here the high tide will be, here the low tide. And what about the tidal range? So earlier the low tide were here somewhere. Now the low tide will be here. Low tide, because here the low tide will be formed, its gravitational pull is less. But here, so earlier if they are the low tides during the spring tide. So this time, low tide will be here. Earlier the spring tides, high tides were here. Now the high tides will be here. These high tides. So this difference has decreased. This difference has decreased. So these are called as neap tidal range. So tidal range will always lie between neap tidal range and the high tidal, that is spring tidal range. So here the list will be formed, high tide. Similarly, this moon can be at this position as well. Again, moon attracts, sun attracts. So very less bulge will be formed here. Is this clear now? Anyone have doubt? Yes. You can ask the doubt now.
So can you explain this? Of this.
Once again, please ask.
So this dotted line, what does it represent?
Okay. Just see here. We draw it again. Okay, separately I draw. Okay. So this is the land. Here the sea we have. Similarly here, we have the sea. Okay. 1 minute. Okay. Now see here, when the spring tide was occurring, this was the low tide and this was the high tide. Okay, this difference is more, spring tidal range. This is spring tidal range. Now this time what will happen? The low tide will not be that low. It will be low tide and high tide won't be that high. This is high tide. These are the condition at this place. Okay. So this will be the near tidal range. You can see the difference between the low tide and the high tide. It is least. Here it is maximum. Between tidal range, it is maximum. Difference between the low tide and the high tide. And here the difference is least. It is called as near tidal range. So one important use of these tides. See here, if this is very shallow shore, so when the high tide is there, it will be filled with water. So large ships can enter the harbor, can leave the harbor safely when the high tide occurs. So this is how the tide has been like for entering of the ship, for leaving of the ship.
So time.
Time is over. Okay, any more doubts you have?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, if there
sir,
is.
Sir, can we leave?
Yes, you can leave. Okay, yes, ask. Those who want to leave,
sir,
they can
leave. Sir, if there is a reason behind that lunar day is of 24 hours and 52 minutes.
Okay, see here, what is happening? Earth is there, moon. Okay, now Earth is moving in which direction? West to east, as well the moon is moving from west to east, around the Earth. Okay, in this direction as well moon is moving. So what happens? See here, if this place sees the moon at this time, okay, now as it is moving, moon as well moving. So next time, it will see the place moon here, when this place reaches here, okay. Moon takes 28 days to roll around the Earth. And Earth, so because of this, extra time it is 24 hours, 52 minutes, lunar day. It will see the moon after this much hours again here, because moon has as well moved. In a day, moon has as well moved here. So next time, the same place will see the moon when it reaches this position, not this one. That's why it is 24 hours, 52 minutes. This 52 minutes extra. Have you understood now?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes. Any more doubts? So question answers, you can go through that video uploaded on 1st October. So all the question answers we have discussed there. Okay?
Sir, can we leave?
Yes, you can leave.
Thank you.